So once again, now that you have a selection made or activated with your magic wand tool, now it's time to color it. Remember, we locked the line art layer, so each new color will get its own layer. You can click the little plus at the bottom for a brand new layer. I'll double click right on the name and call that Golden Sun. And I'll hit return on my Mac or enter on a PC to accept the name. And what you also want to keep in mind, like I showed you before, is no color goes above your line art. So you pull your colors below the line art layer. Here's the color choice I have. I don't want a red sun. I'm going to come down to the gold, go up into the upper right corner to get kind of the purest gold that I can. And then there's a couple of ways to fill this area. The first is Edit Menu and Fill. And this box is going to ask you, what are you trying to fill that area with? I pick my foreground color and I click OK. So there's one area. Okay, if you don't want to use that, you can go to Edit, Undo. And the faster way is by using a keyboard shortcut. On a Mac, I would hold my Option key and then at the same time hit the big Delete key. Option and Delete. Okay. On a PC, I would hold Alt and at the same time hit the Backspace key. Alt and Backspace means fill with the foreground color on a PC. Option and the big Delete key on a Mac means fill with the foreground color on a Mac. So there's my golden sun. Okay, you are trapped inside these areas, these little marching ants. They kind of provide a boundary for you to drop in your paint. So if you are done on a Mac, you hit Command key and the letter D to deselect. On a PC, you would hold your Control key and hit the letter D to deselect. So I always recommend you jump back to your magnifying tool. You can click and drag to the left, hold your space bar and move it up. And we have our flat color. Okay, if you want to try a few more areas just to decorate a little bit more, let's add a little more gold. In fact, I don't want to call this Golden Sun anymore. I'm going to double-click the name and we'll just call this All Golds right there. So remember, if I want to make more selections, I come back up to the line art. Now I go to my magic wand. I can hold my space bar and kind of move this around. And I'll do some of the jewelry on this character. So I might click this little ring. Hold shift and click that ring. I'm gonna hold shift and select inside these little spaces right here, all these little decorative designs. Shift click, shift click, shift click, shift click, and shift click. And let's do a couple of these gold areas up here. Shift click, shift click, shift click, shift click, shift click. And we'll do these two. Shift click. Shift click. I can select a whole bunch of areas. So now that I have all those selected, I'm done using my magic wand. Select menu, modify, expand by 1 pixel. So you jump past those gray pixels. I come back down to my golds and I'll just zoom out here so you could see this a little better. And again, on a Mac, I hold the Option key and hit the big Delete key. On a PC, I would hit Alt key and the Backspace key. So there's my flat colors. That's one method. And if I look closely, yikes, this didn't quite fill. In fact, the magic wand couldn't get into that thin little space, so it kind of got cut off. And I wasn't expecting that. So again, Command D on a Mac, that'd be Control D on a PC. If I missed a spot, I have to come back up to line art. That's where I can use my magic wand. So we'll select that area. Select, modify, expand. I come back down to the golds. And again, on my Mac, option and delete. On a PC, that would be alt and backspace. And there we go. Always check before you're done. Command D on a Mac. There'll be Control D on a PC. And there is my first colorization method. Flat areas of color. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to do layer styles. Special effects for colored areas. Like bevels and embossing and things like that. We'll add a little dimension to these little jewels on her head. So I'll see you in a few minutes when you join me for the next tutorial.